My name is Sue Park. I am a first-year PhD student at University of California, Los Angeles. I'm about to start a project that's focusing kind of on the injury response of the heart. So when the heart is damaged, there are cells within the heart that react to this damage, and so the goal is to kind of understand the mechanism of how these cells are working and potentially using that knowledge to develop therapeutics for when people get heart attacks or other kind of heart failure disorders. I spent the majority of my life growing up in Riverside, California, and I did my undergraduate studies at University of California, San Diego. I think that why I became a scientist is really because I couldn't really think of something else I would rather be doing. So my dad is actually a scientist at University of California, Riverside, so he actually studies plant biology there. And so actually when I was growing up, at times me and my brother wouldn't have a babysitter, so we would actually go with my dad to his lab. And to me then, the laboratory was such a fascinating place. I couldn't understand anything that was going on there, but I think that made it much more magical to me growing up. That just kind of developed into my interest now. Back in college, I actually went on a service trip to a country called Guyana in South America, and the trip was actually focused on the social justice issues of health and how there's a lot of kind of problems with the healthcare systems in a lot of different countries, including our own. It's not really perfect. And so I think that trip really did kind of direct me towards doing health-related research. As I decided to go into medical research or translational research, I wanted to pick a field that I thought could impact a lot of people in the world. And kind of that service trip back then kind of opened my eyes to how there are a lot of people who need healthcare or help need and quality medicinal care, and now I want to do research that could potentially help a lot of people worldwide. So right now I would say my mission is to kind of learn more about the field and kind of understand better what kind of experiments I can do, techniques, and plan out my future projects. Definitely learning a lot of new kind of instrumentation that we have in the lab, such as using the microscopes or doing cell culture work, and just kind of new techniques that I didn't know about. And I think that is my, as of now, short-term mission.
Hey Sue, how's it going? What are you doing?
So I'm basically going to do a PCR reaction.
Uh-huh.
So I really and I'm basically helping Ron with a lot of her work, but we want to run the PCR reaction, run it through a John, basically see if we can quantify or semi-quantify the expression of certain genes from these cultures. I would say that my mission is really to kind of contribute to the cardiology field in some way. I'd really like to have my experiments not just be successful, but at least within the field have some kind of, leave a mark, in the field. My hopes and dreams as a scientist are really to learn as much as I can while I'm here, while I'm a student, but also to have my work contribute to other people's research, especially in the field of cardiology. I'd really like to be able to produce results that can eventually become beneficial to medicine or beneficial to research. And if you're considering being a scientist, I honestly think that it's a profession that should be pursued by those who are passionate about it. It's not easy, but it's really rewarding, and it's, I think, a job that not everybody can do. We're always pursuing what we want to do. We're always pursuing our own interests in terms of like what we want to study. I think that kind of freedom is something that a scientist should have. And if you're considering being a scientist, I think you should go for it, because it's hard, but it's very rewarding.